The US Army has launched a program to rapidly outfit soldiers with a portable drone designed to neutralize tanks. The service is expediting the deployment of a novel kamikaze drone aimed to provide infantry with extended situational awareness. This drone will also be able to detect and eliminate enemy tanks and other significant targets beyond their immediate field of view. The drone is known as the Low Altitude Stalking and Strike Ordnance, or LASSO. Specifically tailored for infantry brigade combat teams, the suicide drone is anticipated to be provided to soldiers by 2024. In this video, Defense Updates reports on US Army's proposed new drone, Low Altitude Stalking and Strike Ordnance. Let's get into the details. The protracted Ukraine-Russian conflict has thrown in many new aspects. The LASSO initiative is based on insights gained from recent military engagements. Though deployed in various conflicts in recent years, notably in Nagorno-Karabakh in 2020 and Syria since 2011, drones have taken on a new dimension since the war in Ukraine, which was started by Russia on February 24, 2022. Since the commencement of the Russian invasion, both military forces have been using hundreds of unmanned aerial vehicles on a daily basis. First-person view, or FPV, drones, which are lightweight, portable, and expendable systems designed for kamikaze-style missions, are being used more extensively than ever before. Drones have gradually established themselves as an essential weapon for both sides. LASSO is designed to be carried by individual soldiers and consists of three parts: a launch tube, an unmanned aerial system, and a fire control station. After being launched from the tube, the drone is capable of scanning the ground for potential targets. The operator gains a view of the battlefield below via the drone's electro-optic/infrared sensor. The operator can react to requests for enemy engagement, flying to sectors indicated by friendly troops as housing enemy tanks, or simply surveying the area for potential targets. Once a suitable target is identified, the drone descends and eliminates it using an anti-tank warhead. The LASSO program falls under the jurisdiction of the Program Executive Office Soldier, PEO Soldier. This effort tackles the urgent need for effective unmanned systems in combat scenarios. It's most likely that further advancements would enhance greater range and endurance in the future and enable these drones to strike targets in the even rear areas of the battlefield, adding much greater lethal capability to infantry soldiers. The US Army is currently in the process of finalizing contract specifics with the defense industry to fulfill this objective, primarily aiming to utilize existing systems in the early stages of the LASSO program. The fledgling LASSO program might engage various companies to provide anti-tank drones for the US Army's use. In this regard, it should be taken into account that the US possesses a strong military-industrial complex, with several companies working in the small drone arena. Assistant Secretary of the Army for Acquisition, Logistics and Technology, Doug Bush, on August 7th, told reporters the service would leverage competition as well as maybe having more than one version to ultimately boost production capacity and meet demands. He added, "There are a lot of companies in that space." He did not mention vendors by name. Bush said early increments of LASSO might resemble some of the things that have been sent to Ukraine. Viewers may note that the US has committed billions of dollars of security assistance to Ukraine, and the aid includes hundreds of AVEX Aerospace Phoenix Ghost and AeroVironment Switchblade one-way drones. A recent package, unveiled July 25th, also featured Black Hornet spy drones from Teledyne FLIR. Tanks play a key role in modern battlefields due to several reasons, which include potent firepower, solid protection, mobility, and ability to support infantry. It's no secret that countries with major militaries have hundreds and even thousands of tanks in their force. But kamikaze drones provide a way to neutralize them effectively. The ability to attack beyond the line of sight is something that makes them very flexible and suitable for fast-paced warfare. Lieutenant Colonel Aaron Pearsall, the Army's product manager for soldier precision targeting devices, told Janes in a July 21st interview, "The Army is preparing to engage near-peer threats in a conventional conflict, and it was becoming evident that our infantry brigade combat teams, IBCTs, are in need of an additional organic anti-tank capability." Although delivered to the IBCTs, Lieutenant Colonel Pearsall said the Army is focused on giving that battalion commander the organic LASSO capability, pushing the UAV's use down to smaller units. Lieutenant Colonel Pearsall said, "We're going after current capabilities, UAVs, that are mature right now, that give us that anti-tank capability." The global military community is observing the ongoing conflict between Ukraine and Russia for insights. Armor warfare will never be the same after this conflict. The U.S. military is particularly attentive, given its pivotal role as Ukraine's primary arms supplier. Small kamikaze drones hold the potential for large-scale deployment, even if multiple drones are needed to neutralize a single adversary platform, like a tank or an armored personnel carrier, the investment remains justifiable. For example, Russian T-90 is thought to cost $4.5 million, whereas a Chinese Type 99 costs $2.5 million. The economy is just too hard to ignore. LASSO could significantly amplify military capabilities, granting infantry enhanced situational awareness and precise targeting abilities beyond their previous operational scope. The transition from a theoretical concept to a tangible product will be interesting to observe.
We are active on Twitter. Follow us there for real-time updates. Link in description section.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.